Sometimes, even to live is an act of courage. That quote is by Lucius Annaeus Seneca, a vividly accurate statement that would describe the life of an old beggar. I would like to recognize Sarah Good today in a speech that I prepared to share, a speech to describe who Sarah Good was in the Salem Village. I want to tell you about the Sarah that the Salem Village knew. This woman was labeled an old hag, known better for society for her begging and cursing. But they didn't know the real Sarah Good. I knew her, and this is what I know about her life and character. It is because of what she's been through in her life, I carefully consider the choices I make whenever I see a beggar. Ever since her family ruin, she had been homeless for a long time. Sarah and her family relied on charity to live throughout another day. People would either help the family by giving them pounds, or they would see it as God's will to personally help them instead. As a good Christian, I devoted my time to do God's work for Sarah Good. I look back now and remember a scene that played itself out many times whenever I passed by Miss Sarah. I would see a weary woman in her 30s. She was cast out by society and the church, begging from door to door, hoping to have at least something to fill her empty stomach. Almost every day I would see her sitting on the church steps or around the village holding out her cup to each person she came upon. For some reason, I pitied her one day and went to talk to her. As I approached, she started to mumble under her breath something I couldn't make out. She mumbled quite often. I asked her what she said, and she told me to mind my own business. I felt like she was saying that I could have a seat next to her. I asked her many things about her life, and she asked me about mine. At the end of the day, I asked her one more question. Sarah, why don't you ever come to church? She said, you said it yourself, that you're a woman of God. So why don't you come to the Salem Church? Sarah gave it some thought before answering my question. The reason I don't come to church is that I am not wanted there. People don't want to see this person who begs all around town in a holy place. They want everyone to be the same and follow the same rules. I don't follow their rules. I'm individually independent, one who is not like society. This is why so many people frown upon my presence. That's the reason I do not go to social places like church. From that day, I had always treasured our conversations. They were genuine. And she talked to me like I was her friend. So as you heard, my friend Sarah Good was treated and thought of as an old beggar. I can't help but to think that if any of you would have taken the time to talk with her, you would have understood that she wasn't a bad person. She died because others didn't believe she was a godly woman. Sarah was accused of doing witchcraft. And as hard as she tried to tell society that she had never done such a thing, no one would listen. My friend died because she didn't want to confess to something she didn't do in the first place. Today, I miss her presence around Salem, but I know she's in a better place now.